Just to start off, and just for us to know, okay, what are the problems that we're facing as a group, as a community, and how can all of us come together to see what solutions we can do? Because it's very common. Many people have very common challenges. So if we can see how each other, we can also try and help each other. That's the whole idea of having this conversation. So
these are the challenge. One is the finance thing. Right, and the secondly, the other challenge that we are going to face was what's the plan next year as far as academic is concerned,
right,
and as far as student engagement is concerned, because there's going to be a lot of time that is going to be wasted in terms of when the school is going to reopen, right? So there's a news that the schools will be reopening somewhere in August, and we are going to lose a lot of time, and that is one challenge. The other challenge is that even if students do come to school, we will not have full attendance because there are certain parents who will not allow the students their wards to come to school unless and until they are very sure that the pandemic is over, or they care more for the health of their wards rather than sending them to school. So these are some issues that came up with respect to the syllabus that has to be taken up, even if it starts somewhere in August or July or August somewhere. So the issue of the syllabus will be coming into consideration. How to go about actually...
Definitely.
Yeah, we can't go on a fast mode, certainly. And also, we'll have the challenge will be that half the students are there in school, half are in home. How are you going to cater to both of them?
So we are budget school, so we still have to think about how to pay the salaries for our teachers. So finances has become a problem because we are not... collected the fees for 2019 itself. One more thing that Chandrasekhar sir raised was like the main of the school during April and May. Like that's when all the schools like they tried to like probably get some construction done or some maintenance that was pending that was being done. We are not so sure when the schools are going to open and how many students are going to turn up, and if there is any kind of a online mode that we can engage, even if we can try. But most of the students who are there, they're not from, I mean, they don't have access to internet. Some of them might have, not everyone might have it. So we're still not sure how many people can attend through online teaching mode. So these are the main concerns that we'll discuss in school.
The challenge is what we have, drop may increase. So students' learning will be hampered because they are very playful now, and that impact will be there when the school start also. And student engagement will be a big task for the teachers. Student behavior management should be taken seriously once the school starts. And now less time for planning. So improv or like not proper planning may lead to some confusion later part also.
How it's becoming a struggle to plan for the next. So that was also shared along with what Raji did.
My other concern was the student engagement. How effective will the engagement be, and will it actually replace the classroom learning? Is what the concerns.
The teachers, availability of teachers also, that also will be a, going to be a problem. That is what I feel. And
so now we are going to spend our next 30 minutes to prioritize our concerns and take suggestions and think and discuss about our next steps with our small group members. We'll be going back to our smaller groups.
And now whatever learning is being done online, students are encouraged to make notes of the questions that they have, of what they have not understood. And it becomes easier for teachers in a shorter period of time to address this rather than address the whole content as a whole.
And we were also looking at a few resources. So we found certain interesting online resources, which I think your respective STLs can share with you. There are like comprehensive lists how we should focus on the skills and competencies more. So there are these certain, I think Avanti has very nice resources, Pratham. So these are resources which are available, and we've collated some of it. So
we can have some kinds of a groups like kindergarten group and then primary group, like that. Four groups it can be made. And then what the group has to be created. That is the only way I feel that in the absence of this provision to read by the bulk SMS, If that is not working out, we have to create this one. And second thing is, looks it is a long way to go.
Yeah.
And at least for 2 months, we have to plan.
Sure,
next
sir.
2 months,
sure,
how
sir.
To reach the parents and all that.
Yeah.
Even we have a staff WhatsApp group also. We are sending the links to the parents for nursery with the collaboration of Radiant Stars India and the Key Foundation. They are sending the links.
If there are any things which you already have an idea about and you would want other school leaders, other schools also to take that up, please mention that also in the form itself.
We at Mantra, we are trying to involve the teachers, students, parents, everybody during this phase, and we are trying to make it as productive as possible.
So thank you so much for joining. I think this has been a very nice experience for us. Hopefully it was very nice for you also, and you've gotten some idea to work on the challenges in the school. I know this is not the end of solution making, but thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you.